Let's see our equation. Again, we have absolute value. It means we have to use definition of absolute value. We have to consider two cases. First, when the value between absolute value bars is positive or equal 0. It will be first case. And the second will be when the value between absolute value bars is negative. So let's do first case. We have x squared plus 7x plus 10 is greater than or equal 0. We have to solve quadratic inequality. To solve quadratic inequality, we have to first find the roots, next we have to draw the graph, and from graph we will find the value greater than or equal 0. So first we have to solve quadratic equation equal 0. So we can use factoring. I have to find two numbers which multiplied by each other give me 10, and when I add them I will have 7. So it will be x plus 2 and x plus 5. Now, when the left side will be 0? When x plus 2 will be 0 or x plus 5 will be 0? So x equals negative 2 and x equals negative 5. Now we have to draw the graph. The graph for quadratic inequality is parabola. Because the coefficient before x squared is positive, the parabola will be open up. And we have roots negative 5 and negative 2. Because we have inequality greater than or equal, it means negative 5 is included and negative 2 is included. We have to find the value greater. Whatever is above our number line, this part is above, and this is our solution. So let's write the interval. We have two intervals from negative infinity to negative 5, close on negative 5, plus interval from negative 2 to positive infinity, close on the left side. So we have the domain. When we have the domain, we can go to our equation. Let me copy first this example. We have x squared minus 3x. This is equal absolute value of x squared plus 7x plus 10 plus 10. Now, when I get rid of absolute value bars, I have to just copy the expression between these two bars. So I will have x squared minus 3x is equal x squared plus 7x plus 10 plus 10. Now I will collect all terms on the left side. So it will be x squared minus x squared minus 3x minus 7x is equal 10 plus 10 is 20. X squared and x squared will cancel, and I have negative 10x is equal 20. Now I will divide both sides by negative 10. Negative 10 and negative 10 will cancel, and I have x is equal 20 by negative 10 is negative 2. Now I have to check if this number is included in our domain. Negative 2 is included. It means we have first solution. X equals negative 2. Now we have to go to the second case. Our expression between absolute value bars, it means x squared plus 7x plus 10 must be less than 0. because before we solve inequality, the same, on the left side we have expression the same, only the different sign. Now we have to find the value less than zero. Less than zero is this part. So we can use this graph, we don't have to solve again. We just write our value less than zero is from negative 5 to negative 2. An open interval because we have sign less than. It means negative 5 to negative 2. We have open interval. This is our domain for the second case. Let me copy our equation first. We have x squared minus 3x is equal x squared plus 7x plus 10 plus 10. Now, when we get rid of absolute value bars, we have to put negative sign before this whole expression in absolute value bars. So the beginning is the same. We have x squared minus 3x is equal negative, and in parentheses I will put x squared plus 7x plus 10 plus 10. Now, because we have negative sign, we have to change the sign in every terms. So we have x squared minus 3x is equal negative x squared, negative 7x, negative 10 plus 10. Negative 10 and 10 will cancel, and I will move all terms to the left side. So we have x squared plus x squared minus 3x plus 7x is equal 0. X squared plus x squared will be 2x squared. Negative 3x plus 7x will be plus 4x equals 0. So we have quadratic equation. We can factor 2x will be x plus 2. When the left sign will be 0? When 2x will be 0 or x plus 2 will be 0. So we have first equation. We divide both sides by 2. So x is equal 0. And I will move positive 2 to the right side, so it will be x equals negative 2. When we have these two solutions, we have to check if they are included in our domain. 0 is not included. Negative 2 is not included because we have open interval. So it means these two numbers are not solution. In this case, we don't have solution. No solution. And now at the end we have to put together these two cases. In first we have solution x equals negative 2. In second we don't have. So together we have x equals negative 2. This is our answer.